Welcome to the SOFiSTiK online documentation. The following video focuses on the input for the Earthquake RSA reloaded task. The finite element model shown here was generated from the Revit model by using analysis and design for Revit 2022. Loads defined in the Revit model were also exported and calculated. Therefore, an additional linear analysis of the loads is not needed. Furthermore, the definition of story levels and the calculation of center of mass and rigidity was done with the help of analysis and design for Revit 2022. Earthquake analysis based on the response spectrum analysis will be carried out using the Earthquake RSA reloaded task. Input is divided in three tabs of equal importance: Eigenmodes and Actions, Response Spectra, and Results. First tab is focused on the input for the eigenvalue analysis and on the definition of the seismic excitation directions. Computational method, maximum number of eigenmodes, and storage load case number can be modified. The default values assigned by the task were not changed in this example. Usually when performing a model superposition, all computed eigenmodes will be taken into account, regardless of the significance of their contribution to the structural response. This may lead to longer computational time because a large number of modes needs to be computed. Mode filtering enables a selection of a subset of the computed eigenmodes, allowing for only the most relevant modes to be considered. Two filtering options are available: set total mass participation per direction, where the considered effective model mass amounts to at least the selected percentage input, and set minimum threshold of mass participation per direction, where all computed modes with effective model mass greater than the input threshold value are taken into account. Furthermore, to avoid vertical slab eigenvalues, the option to eliminate local vertical eigenmodes is available. Model damping values, shear and bending stiffness reduction, and inertial effects can be specified for primary and secondary groups in the following two tables. By default, all the defined primary groups in the model have a damping value of 5%, with a full shear and bending stiffness contribution and inertial effects considered. Additionally, for the below ground level stories, which have the primary groups 410 and 440 assigned, we have disregarded the inertial effects. In this way, the activation of 90% effective model masses in both X and Y direction can be achieved with a smaller number of eigenmodes. To accommodate the design code provision for a 50% reduction of the bending and shear stiffness properties, in case if a more accurate analysis of cracked elements is not performed, we have assigned this value as an example to the secondary groups containing the walls of the building's core. The task also offers a possibility to define additional masses from the analyzed loads by using the table Load Case Selection for Load to Mass Conversion. The available load cases from the database are automatically listed together with the mass effect factor, which are determined per default based on the action type. We have selected the full conversion of the additional dead load and only the 30% of the variable load into the nodal masses. Regarding the definition of the seismic directions, we have selected the horizontal excitation in X and Y direction. Furthermore, the method for the combination of the effects of the directional components of the seismic action needs to be defined. We have selected here the directional combination according to the SRSS method. As an alternative, the task offers directional combination according to the Newmark method. Furthermore, the accidental torsional effects can be considered automatically by the task. In these cases, the calculated center of mass for each floor will be considered as being displaced from its nominal location by an accidental eccentricity. Accidental eccentricity is defined as a percentage, by default 5%, of the floor dimension perpendicular to the direction of the seismic action. In this tutorial, both eccentricities in X and Y direction have been selected, which results with the analysis of maximum four directional combinations. For each combination, the SRSS method will be performed and the results will be stored in four load case groups. Response Spectra tab is divided into four sections: general information about the response spectrum and three group boxes for the X, Y, and possibly Z direction. First, the general information about the response spectrum needs to be specified. We chose here the design spectrum of type 1 with a soil class A according to Eurocode 8. The corresponding spectrum parameters are then automatically calculated. Per default, only the settings in X direction are available for modification. For other directions, in this case only Y direction, the same settings will be automatically adopted. This can be changed by selecting the checkbox Individual Settings. Information about the ground acceleration and the factor used as a multiplier of the spectral values needs to be explicitly given by the user. We have also specified 1.5 as the value of the behavior factor for the design spectrum according to Eurocode 8. In the Results tab, selection of the result options can be modified. The number of generated load cases is dependent on the selection of the excitation directions and the accidental eccentricities. Furthermore, the result load case base number determines the start of a range reserved for the result load cases. Results of the previously mentioned four directional combinations will be stored inside of this range in four load case groups in increments of 100. In each group, the analyzed result type will be stored in a load case number defined with an offset number. Selection of the result type and information about the corresponding load case number offset is available in the following table. All the calculated load cases are assigned to the earthquake seismic action A. More information about the calculated load cases and the numbering scheme can be found after calculating the task in the generated report. It is important to differentiate the model response superposition scheme from the directional combination methods given in the tab Eigenmodes and Actions. The following scheme defines the superpositioning method of the model results for each analyzed direction of the seismic action. Complete quadratic combination is set as a default method. Furthermore, square root of sum of squares and sum of absolute values methods are also available. Finally, by clicking OK, the task can be calculated. If the eigenmodes were previously calculated and the changes in the task do not have a direct impact on their values, the typically time-consuming procedure of recalculating eigenmodes can be avoided with the selection of the following checkbox. We'll proceed now with the calculation of the task. Calculated eigenmodes can be checked now in the system visualization. In the task's report, the information like eigenvalues, the sum of affected model masses, and the generated result load cases can be found. This is the end of the video. Thank you for your attention.